Our trip in Korea began with cool and challenging activities. We also met promising talents during the tryouts, witnessed a unique vibe in Myeongdong, and challenged ourselves with an extraordinary meal. I'm a lifelong martial artist, and I have a knack for finding talent, which is why I've traveled more than 10,000 miles from my home in search of the next warrior. This is Asia. Join me, Rich Franklin, three-time middleweight world champion, on a journey to experience the cultures that gave birth to martial arts and meet the rising prospects on this side of the world. We will learn the flavors, the beauty, the customs, and the pains Asia has to offer.
I'm okay.
These martial artists will compete for a one championship contract exceeding $100,000 and the honor to be called the Blue Warrior.
Jonathan and I started asking all the athletes that tried out, like, if they'd ever taken taekwondo before. And most of them said yes, that they had at some point in their life taken taekwondo lessons, typically when they were kids. Pretty much every parent puts their kid in this sport for some period of time. So, Jonathan and I decided to pop into a taekwondo class.
Dude, I'm about to get cracked by kids.
Says Jonathan Fong and all this says my name?
Yeah, Rich Franklin.
This one's calling me out right here. This one right here, me and him.
Uh-huh.
He's already making like eye contact.
Yeah,
I know what's up.
What the?
It's pretty demoralizing, particularly when all the other students are like 9. Somebody at my level becomes the worst student in the class.
빠르게 올렸다가 빠르게 내리는 거 준비. 한번 놓고 시작.
You have to kick.
This girl holds her foot up for like a second.
Some of the techniques required a significant amount of balance. And holding those poses for an extended period. So I struggled.
Thank you guys. I've been doing martial arts for many years, but I've never done taekwondo before. And so being in this class today, it was quite difficult doing some of the moves the way that you guys do them. Thank you for having us in the class today. I really appreciate your time.
We decided we were going to take Kim Ju-won out for lunch. It was actually pretty cool watching him show up because the class was over. The kids were asking for autographs. Kim Ju-won walks in. They knew that I had recruited him for this organization. And the kids were really excited to meet him as well. And so all the kids in the class run over to get his autograph.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
See you next time. Bye-bye. All right, we'll see you soon. Bye.
The bibimbap restaurant for me was a rare occasion because it's one of the few times that I actually get to eat healthy food when I'm on the road. And it was also nice to have Jonathan cook our food and serve it to us while I got to sit there and spend some time with Kim Ju-hwan and know him a little bit.
Rich Franklin is not the only chef in this production crew. Oh, I didn't see that. Thank you, Sunny.
This is a symbol of five different colors. It must contain the five different colors of like the flag. Bibimbap. It's the harmony of the five different colors of Korea.
Soft, crunchy.
부드럽고.
I like it with the chili sauce. It does taste very, very clean.
That's one of the most important parts of your body, so he wanted to give a meaningful tattoo. So he put two hands that they're praying.
Back at the tryouts, every athlete is crashing the pads with their strikes, trying to outshine each other in order to move on to the next round. For the first portion of the tryout, we have the athletes step onto the mats with one of their coaches, and they do pad work.
The stand-up is...
Time! Ready? With your coaches. Go! His elbow is heavy.
7-7, 4 knockouts, 3 decision wins.
Yeah. Time! Your amateur record, these are MMA fights also?
15.
15 fights, okay. I just want to make sure they were amateur, MMA. Cool. That's it, you got any questions or anything? All right, thank you guys.
감사합니다.
Okay, keep these two, get rid of the others.
Both?
Yeah. The second stage of the tryouts, we have the athletes flow grapple with our coaches so that we can once again assess technique. But then we will pair them up according to weight and have them grapple in live situational drills.
We had a number of expats show up at the tryouts in Seoul, and two of the guys who stood out were Brennan and Cody.
Good pushing that head.
That would happen right away.
Come on, Cody.
Time.
So you said here, Google Meet, and you will find out I've successfully overcome adversity. Can you give us just like a short synopsis on that?
Yeah, I got in huge trouble. Huge high speed chase when I was trying to get money to go to TriStar Gym, and then messed up, had to go to jail time, and then got out, moved out to Alberta, a month and a half in a gym. I gave him my first pro fight, and I've just been going since then. Like, I was with Tim Hagg, and he passed away, and Steve Bergeron, but yeah, those guys got me in. I've just been going hard since then. Like, I'm a personal trainer and student massage therapist, and I want this more than I want to breathe air, man, straight up.
Awesome, okay. Cool, man.
I wouldn't have flew here if I didn't want it.
Yeah, obviously. Yeah.
Appreciate you coming out. Cheers. Thanks.
Cody created a GoFundMe page to travel to the tryouts that I had in Beijing to try out there. Because he had visa issues, the money that he raised, he used to fly to Seoul. When I see somebody that puts that kind of effort, the thought of turning them away actually breaks my heart. You can tell he's a scrappy person, but not somebody with a very refined skill set. So I had to pass on it.
So you're here?
Yes, sir.
What brought you to Korea?
Just a change in life. I've always been adventurous, and I always felt the need to travel, see the world, because if I stay home in Georgia and South Carolina, I'm gonna die an old man faster, because life is dwindling away, so.
I've been to Athens. I've been there.
Oh, yes, it's real beautiful. I miss it sometimes.
Brennan had grown up training in Taekwondo his entire life, and he decided that he wanted to relocate to Korea. The One Warrior Series tryout was there, and he decided that he wanted to come in and try out for the show. But unfortunately, you could tell that his martial arts skills outside of Taekwondo were a bit limited. And the moment that he hit the ground, he had serious problems. How long have you been training?
저 운동 딱 시작한 거는 4개월 전인데 제가 교통사고 당해서 제대로 시작한 건 2개월 정도 돼요.
저는 제대로 안 하고 2주 됐습니다. 2주. 운동하는 거지 2주 됐습니다.
How old are you?
만으로 17살이요. 00년생이요.
He's born in 2000.
Millennium, good man.
You're the perfect example of what this competition's all about, because we're looking for young talent. Just not that young. I can tell that you've only been training for 4 months because there are some things that you do really, really well. And there are some things that I can tell you just don't have experience yet either, right? But I want you to know that we are coming back in later this year, when probably around the time that you'll be 18. And I want you to try out again because I want to see how much better you've gotten. How long have you been training?
운동하다가
네.
이 세인프로 3연상 하다가
네.
이제 회사 들어갔어요.
운동 기간?
기간은 25대부터 지금 한 6년, 7년.
6 years, 7 years.
예,
6, 7 years.
But he has stopped in the middle.
Gotcha. Amateur MMA record is 301.
예.
Yes.
이름은 이현진이고 그리고 나이는 한국 나이로 올해 31하고 만으로는 31살입니다. 그리고 현재 경남 통영에서 저의 체육관을 운영하고 있습니다. 종합격투기는 이제
I was quite impressed with Lee Yu-jin when he tried out. He threw some fast hands, good combination, looked quick on his feet, looked really well-rounded on the ground. I like the way that he flowed.
제가 어릴 때부터 이제 사고를 엄청나게 많이 치고 다니거든요. 솔직히 뭐 말하는 거니까 밖에서는 솔직히 싸움을 해도 상대도 없고 싸울 사람도 없고 해가지고 방황을 좀 많이 했는데 이제 이런 격투기를 알게 되면서 이제 그런 이렇게 잘못된 이제 분노하는 표출 방법을 이제 그런 걸 통해 가지고 할 수 있겠다 싶어가지고 그때부터 배우게 됐습니다. 일단 이 경쟁에 참여한 이유는 일단 저를 믿어주고 그리고 저를 막 끝까지 믿어주는 저희 제자들하고 그리고 제 가족들하고 제 지인들한테 증명하기 위해서 하고 또 하나는 이제 제 실력을 의심하는 사람들한테 또 증명하기 위해서 또 나왔습니다. 그리고 뭐 제 커리어에 뭐 크게 제 커리어를 크게 생각한 게 아니라 그냥 아직 나이가 좀 많은 편인데 아직도 할 수 있다는 것도 좀 보여주고 싶어서 아직도 더 충분히 할 수 있을 것 같아서 지원하게 됐습니다. 덤덤했습니다. 이게 뭐 실감도 잘 안 나고 그냥 그랬습니다. 기분이 좋은 거는 같은데 실감이 잘 안 났던 것 같습니다.
Time. Having spent most of One Warrior Series traveling through Southeast Asia, there hasn't been much of a chance for cold weather activities, which I love. So, when I found out there was a ski and snowboarding resort just 40 minutes outside of Seoul, I had to visit. Welcome to Kongjiang. Because Korea is hosting the Winter Olympics this year,
yeah,
I figured that we would go to Kongjiang Ski Resort and get a little snowboarding in.
I'm excited, man. When's the last time you skied or boarded?
2 weeks ago. When's the last time you boarded?
I've skied once. I was in college in Tremblant.
Okay. Don't get hurt today, because we have more tryouts.
And I need you. Hey, it's okay. I have a great teacher, so all the responsibility falls on you. So we're good. Yeah. We'll be all right.
We're fine. I'm an amazing teacher. Don't worry about that.
We'll be all right.
I'm stoked, but I also know that this is just going to be a very painful experience. It's going to be painful because I'm going to keep falling down, but it's a great learning experience anyway.
Get your foot ready to go onto the backboard.
You know, I had heard that this is something that's a little bit more difficult than skiing for some people, but I thought, you know, why not? I'll be probably learn a thing or two.
Facing up the hill. It's hard to get up that way. There you go. Now get up.
There you go now.
Lean back. There you go. When you're sitting this way, just so you know, if you're sitting this way, it makes it easier to get up. Just roll over like that. Yeah. And now you're on your knees. But you're not facing, you're facing uphill, so it feels weird when you stand up, because you want to be able to see where you're going.
Yeah, but you're on your, if you're on your front toes, it's easy to see.
Heavy on the front leg. Heavy on the front leg now.
This is the hardest part of the day.
My first day snowboarding, I had a friend. I was learning in Alaska at the Alaska mountain range. Yeah. First day snowboarding, at the end of the day, takes me up to the north face. I was looking down this hill, and I'm like, a friend of mine, Tim, I said, Tim, I don't even know if I'd go down this thing on a sled if I was at home. And I'm standing on a board. So I know the feeling. If you look down at the snow, we have good powder here, man.
Like,
this is
very fine.
The snow was a little wet earlier because it was above freezing, but now it's getting colder, and so this is really good conditions. Watch him. See how he's doing that right there, back and forth? That's what you... See, watch her. All right, let's do it, man.
That was so much fun.
I was quite impressed with Liu Jin when he tried out. He threw some fast hands, good combination, looked quick on his feet. So after we were done snowboarding, Jonathan and I decided that we were going to meet him up for dinner.
If you could name one event in your life that has been the most impactful thing that's ever happened to you, like the one thing that has made an impression on you, what would that be?
Best friend is on the 제일 친한 친구가 있었는데 이제 그 친구와 제가 진짜 힘들고 되게 외로울 때 뭐 물질적으로든 아니면 정신적으로든 도움을 엄청 많이 줬어요. 근데 그 친구가 이제 백혈병 걸려가지고 죽었는데 그때 한 3년 정도 엄청 슬펐습니다. 그래가지고 지금도 한 그 친구도 바다를 좋아해가지고 바다를 고향 동네 바다에 뼈를 뿌렸는데 지금도 한 이틀에 한 번 정도는 가서 소주도 부어주고 오고 있어요. 참 생각이 지금도 많이 나요. 보고 싶어가지고.
Is it this event that pulled you away from that lifestyle and then you decided to get into martial arts? Is that how that happened?
꼭 그런 건 아닌데 이제 친구도 운동을 엄청 좋아했어요. 그래가지고 제가 운동 시작하고 온 달 얼마 안 됐을 무렵에 이제 첫 아마추어 시합을 나갈 때 그날이 저는 아직도 생각나요. 3월 4일이 제가 첫 아마추어 시합을 나가는 날이었는데 친구가 꼭 좀 이겼으면 좋겠다고 이렇게 얘기를 하더라고요. 그래서 이겨갖고 갔는데 이제 친구가 그때부터 많이 힘들어져가지고 4월 1일 날 만우절 날 죽었거든요. 원래 담배도 많이 폈었는데 이제 친구하고 약속한 게 담배 끊는 거 약속해가지고 그 뒤로 담배도 끊고 그냥 운동만 했습니다.
Keep in mind that every day, think about the picture of the young man that you showed me, and stories like that. Like every time you help somebody out like that and change their life and turn them around, you're honoring your friend. That's something positive you can always keep in mind about that person.
One Warrior Series has traveled across Asia, taking in incredible cities such as Bangkok, Manila, Tokyo, and Seoul, in search for the best martial artist.
As I sit and think about all these experiences that I've been through, I'm appreciative for every single one of them, because as you see how other people live their lives, something that you perceive, like, for example, I grew up poor, but when I visit a place like the tenement, it makes me realize that poor is a completely different level from anything that I knew when I was 10 years old. And had I never experienced something like that, my perspective on life would only have the basis of the 10-year-old version of me.
We've been privileged to meet the athletes from different cultures with unique stories and phenomenal skills, but united with one passion and one dream to be called the One Warrior.